Most people would probably associate sediments with the dirt underneath their feet. But what if I tell you that with my research, we're able to extract ancient human DNA from exactly that source? Ancient DNA is commonly retrieved from skeletal material and teeth. But as you might know, fossils are very rare. And this is where my research comes into play. My PhD project sets out to develop new methods to retrieve ancient DNA from alternative sources, such as cave sediments, speleothems, or whatever deposits our ancestors left for us to find. Now you could wonder why anybody would rather dig through dirt on the hunt for ancient DNA if it's just so much easier to drill into a skull or isolate the DNA from teeth. These methods, however, are still to some degree invasive. Archaeological sediments, on the other hand, are a much more abundant resource and are easily accessible even at excavation sites where no skeletal remains have been uncovered. This new approach to anthropological deposits is able to answer a broad range of questions in evolutionary anthropology, such as human ancestry, their behavior, dietary composition, and so much more. My work covers a broad spectrum of tasks, including going abroad on excavations, bringing the samples home to our dedicated clean rooms, and processing the samples. Last but not least, bioinformatically analyzing the sequencing data. The task that's the most time-consuming, though, is the lab pipeline. Fortunately, I'm supported by my team of two young and ambitious female scientists who spent their days in the labs extracting DNA from our samples. Not only are we able to extract ancient human genomes from sediments, we can also pick up the DNA of the animals that were roaming the site. This allows us to make conclusions about the paleoclimate. Further, sediments can preserve the genetic material of ancient pathogens. This gives us information about the coevolution of these pathogens and humans. Both of these topics have become increasingly important to our society, especially so during the last couple of years. When I first joined the Department of Evolutionary Anthropology, I immediately felt welcomed and given the chance to develop and flourish as a young scientist. Our new Doc School of Ecology and Evolution adds another layer to this by encouraging us PhD students to network and to present our research to the scientific community. Altogether, the University of Vienna was and continues to be a great choice for conducting my research.